Welcome to Paintable Tips and Tricks, guys. In this video, we're gonna learn how to blend color with the smudge tool. And to demonstrate that, I'm going to use this painting of mine. It's a portrait which has every values, every shadow, every highlight in a geometric shape, and nothing is blended. Personally, I don't start my painting like that, but that way it's gonna be easier for me to demonstrate the tricks and the tips in this video. So how do we blend color with the smudge tool? Lots of people, when they try the smudge tool, they take any brushes that they actually use to paint. And basically what it does is something more like moving the pixels around. But with the right settings, what it will do is this. It's just gonna blur the two colors together. And by passing a few times, you will get that gradient and that blending that you actually want. To get that kind of effect, you just have to set up a tool preset. And if I open my brush panel here, you'll see that I have a little bit of scattering and the transfer is on. And all those settings make sure that my brush, that which looks like that, will give me the blending that I need. I'm not gonna go in deep with the settings here, but what I'll do is I'll make sure that you can download, if you look below this video, you can download the brushes that I'm using, which are actually presets tool, but I'll explain all of that to tell you how to install them. What I wanna do in this video is show you how I use this tool, this smudge tool, to blend this portrait. So I'm gonna create a new layer on top of this one. And I'm going to start blending the colors. So because it's a smudge tool, it's smudging the colors, smudging the pigments. It's going to move them away. If I put my brush really small, it's going to make it just a little bit small. But if I make it bigger, it's going to blend a lot more. Now, if I'm not careful here and I go over the eyebrow, it's just going to smudge everything, which that's not what I want. I just want to blend the colors together. So I'm just going to pass everywhere like this and be careful to try to keep all the values that I need and just smudge them. Now, the main difference between blending color with a smudge tool and blending color with a brush is that I'm not creating any pixels, any pigment. I am just mixing them the way they are on my canvas. So if I needed to add some more pigments, some more values, I would have to use my brush. But if I have already all my values on my painting, I can only use the smudge tool and smudge them like this. It's a very nice tool. It's handy to use at certain moment. I would not necessarily blend all my color with a smudge tool. I think that you would need a little bit more control over what you do, and the brush, the art brush or the soft brush, could be a much better tool for this. But the smudge tool can be really handy when you want to have that blurry effect on a little part of it and keep the rest straight. Like this. So yeah, I have like a transition here that's really cool that the smudge tool gave me the possibility to have. Whoops, wrong tool. If I had to put the pros and cons to this technique, I would say that as a pros, it would blend really easily the colors. I don't have to think about picking the colors and then painting a little bit of brown, painting a little bit of yellow, and doing it back and forth. I just have to basically paint over what's already there, and the smudge tool is going to do the job for me to blend them perfectly. So that's the big pros for this one. The cons is definitely the fact that I don't have any control over the colors that I'm applying. So if I need more colors, I have to use a brush. I have to paint those colors because they don't exist. Like, if I wanted to add more yellow here, I can't really just push them away. I would have to take my brush at this point and paint it. But when it comes to blend, the colors that are already there, the smudge tool is perfect for that. And that's it for this tip. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're interested in trying this technique and using the same brushes that I'm using, just click on the link below the video.